it comes to sports in Bengaluru, Bengaluru fans are crazy about two things. One is the Red Army, the other is Bleed Blue. Yes, you got it right. We are going to talk about Bengaluru FC, the best club not just in Bengaluru but in India. What are their preparations and what can we expect from Bleed Blue in this season?
For them, this is not a football club. It's a passion which goes beyond words. The most passionate fans are their strength. This is the fastest growing football club in the country. The most professional run outfit in India. They stand for loyalty, friendship and honour. Yes, we are all talking about the boys in blue, Bengaluru FC. The talisman of Bengaluru FC remains their skipper, Sunil Chhetri. Captain Chhetri remains their backbone. You can't imagine the team without this man. When he makes his way on the pitch, the boys in blue play like tigers. The new season of ISL is on and Bengaluru FC skipper is confident of his chances.
It just tells you how hard we have worked and where we have reached. I'm really, really happy and I want to congratulate everyone associated with BFC, right from Path, Sajan Jindal to our ball boy. Everyone has worked so hard. But today we are here on this special occasion. It's a personal opinion. You've chosen the best club in the country. I might be biased. We'll try our best to perform as well as possible. And I don't know about the results, but I can guarantee you that as far as on-pitch and off-the-pitch performance is concerned, we'll give our best. I know this club gives their best. I know this club has a motive that every year we want to improve ourselves, and we'll keep doing that.
Can you imagine Team India without Virat Kohli? No, right? The same can be said about Sunil Charismatic Chhetri. Gurpreet Singh Sandhu, the gentle giant. Over 6 feet tall, this man has a presence which is hard to ignore. The number one goalkeeper in India will once again be donning the blue jersey.
The guy standing right next to me is also called the gentle giant of Indian football. Gurpreet, thanks a lot for talking to News 9. A good start, beating Chennai 1-0. What are the plans moving forward?
I think just to stick on the same momentum and try to get a result before the international break against Jamshedpur. And playing at home should be a good advantage for us. And just keep our head down and work for it.
What have been your preparations in particular for this season?
To be honest, just to look at how I played last season and to look at what things I could do better. And just eating well, sleeping well, all the things that I should keep on doing, and an extra focus towards the Asian Cup as well, because that's a big platform, and I would like to use that platform, and if I get the opportunity to perform there. So all these things in mind, I'm just trying to give an extra notch in my preparations.
He is tall, he is dominating, and his presence is intimidating. To safeguard Bengaluru's goalpost, the Blues couldn't have asked for a better guard.
Now, Gurpreet, your association with Bengaluru FC is going from strength to strength. What have you learned from the club, and how has your game improved given when you started off with Bengaluru FC?
I think being at Bengaluru FC has taught me how a player and a club can be together as a family, not just because they are staff and you're players, but how to gel in well together and how to be good friends and family. And that's what Bengaluru is. It's a big family, and they've helped me improve as well, providing that game time that was much needed in my career back then. And week by week, if you get the opportunity to perform, you improve, and Bengaluru FC has given me that.
Gurpreet, what is it about Bengaluru FC that separates it from the rest of the club, and what can we expect from the club moving forward?
I think the amount of professionalism brought in by Bengaluru FC is paramount, and it's something that has been lacking in Indian football clubs, unfortunately. But Bengaluru FC being very professional, and the people understand the player's perspective, and providing all the basic facilities for the least is something which was missed in Indian football. And I think just to improve on that, you know, sponsoring with Kia is one of the biggest steps an Indian football club has taken in the past, I don't know, a decade. So I think it's a step forward, and we should, you know, cherish and enjoy this moment.
This will be Gurpreet's second season with Bengaluru FC, and will be looking for bigger and better things with the club in 2018. He has made 19 appearances for Bengaluru FC and hardly conceded a goal in the last season. By some distance, he was the best goalkeeper last season. Last season was a mixed affair for Gurpreet. The team's form was a great one, and the tall goalkeeper too was at his very best.
Gurpreet, now last season was an excellent one. Everyone was expecting Bengaluru to go the distance. Unfortunately, we lost in the final. So is there a pinch still? And I know that in sports, there's nothing called as revenge, but overcoming them with 1-0, was there some sort of an answer to last year's finals loss?
I think we did go to the distance, and going to two finals is a very big achievement. It's very, very difficult for any team to reach finals, two finals especially. Losing that final, of course, is a disappointing result for us, but you know, getting a win against the same team at home was special, but it wasn't like a revenge feeling or something like that, but still a good feeling to start the season with 3 points. As I said, you know, we were just trying to improve our mistakes, and that's what we did.
So what is it about Gurpreet that at just 26, he is the best goalkeeper in the country? Remember, some of the best players, not just in India, but in the world, play in the Indian League. And Gurpreet invariably has answers for everyone.
Gurpreet, like in the last couple of seasons, what I have personally followed your career, very few, you have conceded very few goals. Is there a particular amount of training that you go about it, or is it like, you know, the regular trainings along with you, along with the anticipation that comes, which is very important for a goalkeeper?
I think it's just about communication, you know. People often see goalkeepers as someone who makes saves and stuff like that. Like, in my opinion, a good goalkeeper is someone who communicates well with their defense and avoids situations before they happen. And that's what I have been trying to do, and that's what I want to do, because a good goalkeeper does that. And once you do that, you don't have to make any saves and you don't concede goals. So that's the philosophy behind it.
Gurpreet is a team man. For him, the team comes first, ahead of personal goals, personal ambitions and personal achievements. That's what makes him a complete team man.
There's a lot of talks in media regarding you and your association with the captain Sunil Chhetri as to how well you guys gel together, plan together and perform on the pitch. So a word or two on Chhetri and how has he led the side?
Anything I say about him is less, because in my opinion, he's the best Indian player we have got, and the kind of professionalism and the kind of focus he has is unmatchable, and he leads us very well. Sometimes he gets pretty emotional on the pitch, but there are guys like me who have a cool head to, you know, calm him down. But he's very focused and wants to win. That's what this club needs, and that's what this club stands for, you know, winning trophies. And, you know, I hope he doesn't finish his football in the next 10, 15 years or so.
The tall Indian goalkeeper also had a message for Blue Brigade Army.
Do come to the stadiums, because we need you. The club is incomplete without you, and we'll try to perform for you as much as we can.
If 2017 was a good one for Gurpreet, he will be looking to go the distance this time. He will once again be challenged, but challenge is what drives this gentle giant. Eric Barthelu, the defensive midfielder.
ISL not only gives a chance for the Indian players to rub shoulders with the overseas player, but also overseas players to get and rub shoulders with the Indian players. I have one such overseas player with me. Eric, thanks a lot for talking to News 9. How are you doing, mate?
Good, yeah. Good pronunciation on the mate. Very good.
Thanks a lot. What can Bengaluru fans expect from you going into the first season, given that you have won your first game of the season? And moving forward, what can one expect from Bengaluru FC?
Yeah, I think we just look to continue our good form. That's the first thing. The first game was a great way to start the season, given the fact we lost to Chennai in the final. That was a game I think we were all motivated for, and you know, if we want to continue in that frame of mind, then we're going to be very difficult to beat. So let's hope against Jamshedpur we can do the same performance again.
Eric, what is it about Bengaluru FC that separates it from the rest of the clubs in India?
For me, it's professionalism. I've seen a lot of other teams across the board, even before I signed, speaking with other players and people that had been in and around Bangalore and Bengaluru FC. It's professionalism. We're a great unit, a great club, professional on and off the field. And I think that reflects the way that we have performed in the last couple of seasons. And obviously getting, you know, sponsors like these guys on board, Kia, it just goes to show you that off the field that we're very polished as well.
Australian Eric Bartholu is an important cog in Bengaluru FC's wheel. It has been just a season for the lanky Australian with the club, but he has made his presence felt both on and off the pitch.
Eric, you have been associated with the club for a season now. As an individual, I'm asking you this. How do you feel your game has improved, given in context the Indian football?
Yeah, for me personally, it's improved massively. I think whenever you come to a new season, a new country to play, and you have to get used to everything off the field, it's more harder than on the field sometimes. But generally in your second season, you feel more comfortable in your surroundings. And that's what I found this year. I've come back for pre-season and, you know, I just felt like I've been at home. And when you play with players for the second or the third season in a row, it makes things a lot easier. But for me personally, like, I feel at home now, and I want to kick on from last year.
Your views on team composition and combination this year compared to the last season?
Fantastic. Like I said, it's going from strength to strength. As Parth mentioned on stage there, we've got five academy players that have come through from Bellary, from the youth team, and that's where this club's looking to help Indian football. It's trying to produce players that can get into the first team and can play in the ISL level and national level. But you know, for me personally, we've got a great bunch of boys there in the club, and I think we're even stronger than last year.
At 32, Eric has wealth of experience under his belt. He exhibits spark like a youngster and plays every match like it is his last match. He has played close to 300 matches, but takes pride in playing for the Blues.
How do you think ISL has helped Indian football?
Yeah, it's in its fifth season now. You know, historically, the I-League obviously goes a long way back, and it would be rude not to mention that, you know, the I-League was obviously a major player in Indian football, but I think in the last, certainly the last two or three years, it's starting to creep above in terms of level. You know, the first couple of seasons of the ISL was, you know, you had a few more foreigners that were, you know, a bit older and retired guys coming back to play, but now you can see the quality of the guys that we're signing. Guys who are in their mid-30s or mid-20s even coming to here to play. And I think clubs are recognising they're going to get more value for players like that. And the Indian players, well, they're learning from guys like us that are here hungry to work, hungry to perform. And I think that's going to help lift the standard.
I'm not trying to tell you to compare things here, but actually, what do you think are the positives and the deficiencies when Indian football is compared to European football or overseas football?
It's just time. I think, you know, time and obviously the coaching aspect. You know, I think now we're seeing a lot of good coaches come through, and, you know, not just coach at the ISL level, but also coaching the youth players, you know, certainly in Bellary as well. And it's just the exposure level. You can't be just playing all these games in the one country and expecting to, you know, to gain knowledge or, you know, gain experience. So now you've got guys in Indian teams and I-League, ISL teams starting and, you know, pre-seasons overseas, playing against different sides, getting that experience. So now it's coming together really nicely. And I think in the next 5 or 10 years that Indian football will be in a much stronger place.
Eric's association with Bengaluru FC started in 2017 season, and he has been a certainty in the 11 given his experience and defensive skills. He has not only defended well, but has also scored 5 goals for the Blues in the last season. Playing for Bengaluru is a matter of pride for Eric. He has played for some of the best clubs, but Bengaluru is just the right club in the last stage of his competitive career.
How has Bengaluru treated you and your message for the fans?
I love being here in Bangalore. You know, the city's great. I'm very, very happy here. I have a great time off the field and on the field. We're very, very focused. We've got a great staff that keep us on our toes and a great bunch of boys. I love going into work every day. We kick each other on the field and off the field we're mates. But, you know, message for the fans is obviously keep supporting us. We're going to put on a good show. And we always promise to try our best, and I'm sure that this season will be successful.
2018 ISL season is on, the competition will be tough, tougher than last season. Bengaluru FC have the support of its fans that have stood by them in good and bad times. Sunil Chhetri and boys have a huge task in hand. 5 titles in 5 seasons, but the last piece of jigsaw puzzle still awaits the Blues.
Expectations are only going to rise from Bengaluru FC with every season. 2018 is no different. Can the Blues bring the cup home, or will it be a disappointment once more? We all have to wait and watch. With camera person Shrikant, this is Abhijit Singh for News 9, Bengaluru.